Hi friends, I'm Dr. Ashutosh Gupta. I'm the consultant fetal medicine. So today we will be talking about multifetal pregnancy and its management. So the human uterus is meant only for a single baby, single fetus. If you add on another fetus into the uterus, so you have to reduce 3 weeks and 3 days to the gestational period that the pregnancy would continue. Meaning thereby, for a singleton pregnancy, the gestational age that the pregnancy goes is up to 38 weeks. And then the fetal weight that we can expect is something around 3 kgs. In a twin pregnancies, we have to reduce the gestational period from 38 weeks to something around 35 weeks. And the fetal weight drastically comes down from 3 kgs to something around 2 kgs or so. That happens very bad in a case of a triplet pregnancy. So the gestational period for a triplet pregnancy would be something around 31, 32 weeks or so. And then the estimated fetal weight that we can have for all the three triplets would be something around 1 to 1.1 kgs. So that is how the things are. So meaning thereby that managing a multifetal pregnancy and getting a reduction done is medically, socially, ethically justifiable option. So we'll discuss all these things in the later case. So our case is for a TADC triplets. So we are having three babies and two sac, dichorionic sac. So meaning thereby that the two fetuses are in one sac. Had it been a case of TATC, so meaning thereby we have had three sacs and three different fetuses and three different sacs, the multifetal pregnancy reduction becomes an easy procedure, which becomes slightly complicated in the case of a TADC2N once we are having a two fetuses and one sac. So as you can see, we are using 26 gauze needle. Through an ultrasound guidance, we are getting through the mother's abdomen into the fetal heart. So we are using very minimal doses of the drug, which is in the incremental doses of 0.1 ml. And then we are waiting for the cardiac asystole to happen. And then we are waiting. So in this case, we were successful in reducing one fetus of the monochorionic set. And then the two fetuses, and she was left with two fetuses. So meaning thereby that she have had a two dichorionic pregnancies and one fetus of the monochorionic set was being deduced. This is how we were able to manage a TADC triplets, converting a TADC into a DADC twins. Thank you.